I am Rohit Gangwal, a volunteer with Team Raksha. In 2003, my injured bird fell right in front of me. I picked it up and tried to save the bird, but I couldn't. I called up many people, but couldn't get much help. And similarly, I thought there's a dire need to help birds during this festivity, which is good for humans, but in a way bad for the avian life like birds. And since then, I thought that something needs to be done. Again, in January 2014, I tried to do a rescue setup, but again, we failed drastically because we did not have very good knowledge about avian medicine. And over 16 birds were rescued, but then all of them died because we did not do any big medical interventions. Again, this made me go into introspection and think about what was going wrong. And in 2005, we again set up a unit with around about 60 birds to be rescued, and 3 or 4 birds were released. This time we did some medical intervention, but not sufficient. So again, I thought that there's a dire need to learn about avian medicine, which is a subject which not many people know. Get people, connect people with India who are working on birds, and give the best possible treatment and facilities to birds for this particular point of time. Initially, we started rescue work for 3 days, then 10 days, then a month. Now we have a permanent bird helpline for Jaipur city currently. And since then, we have advanced in avian medicine facility, and currently we do all kinds of medical interventions, surgical interventions with birds which require lacerations or bone pinning or anything like that. Apart from that, we also do rescue and rehabilitation of birds, which is very important post the avian medicine care which the bird needs to get. So, and Raksha is a youth-based organization. Though I'm growing old now, I'm almost 38, but we are a youth-based organization and totally volunteer-based. Majority, like 95% of the work carried out in Raksha is done by volunteers like you and me. So it's a request that whenever, if you wish to volunteer, not just with Raksha, with any organization, it is very important for the youth to bond and associate for a social cause, because the society needs the youth. And Raksha is a platform where you can come, work and make us move forward.
My name is Anjali Chaturvedi, and I am from Amity University Rajasthan. Me and my teammates went to Raksha Foundation, which is legit a home for animals and birds, right after Makar Sankranti, because we were expecting that there would be a lot many cases of injured animals and they would be needing a lot of desperate need of medical aid. When we went there, we actually witnessed some heart-wrenching scenes where the feathers of pigeons were totally cut off from their body. They were bleeding. Even we saw an eagle which was whose eyes was infected and all of that. It was very, very, very heart-wrenching. And so we decided to do something. And what we decided was to spread awareness and take their interviews, take the people who are associated with Raksha Foundation, and we wanted to make a difference in any of the ways we could. Soon when we went there, we witnessed that there was this operation theatre in which there was a veterinarian who was actually helping and operating a pigeon who lost his eyesight and a foot, and he was trying stitches, and we could actually listen to its painful voice. After that, we saw an administration department where there was a proper implementation of helpline center for Raksha, just in case you as a civilian find any animal, like for any bird in that case injured, you can actually call that helpline And the people from Raksha will take care of that particular bird, and they will make sure that that it gets the stipulated amount of healthcare which is needed for it. After that, we also saw this rehabilitation center which was there situated inside Raksha, where around 50 to 60 of pigeons were captured inside, because they came just after the operation theater, and they were there for their stipulated time, and they were just resting there. Through our social awareness program of behavioral science, we have gotten a chance to visit different parks of Jaipur and also Raksha Foundation. First, talking about Raksha Foundation, I would like to tell you all that this year when we visited Raksha Foundation after Makar Sankranti, fortunately we got to know that we have noticed lesser cases of, you know, injury of birds, or perhaps birds dying this year because of the Chinese manja. Because people have started taking care of their environment, of, you know, birds, flora and fauna. The thing we wanted to do through our social awareness program was that highlight and acknowledge the person who has started this foundation in Jaipur. And you, there are volunteers working for Raksha Foundation like you and me and many others, and the people in our group, in my group. The thing which we need to put in everyone's mind is that we as individuals are, you know, the future of India. If we won't save our environment, our diversity, there would be nothing left for our future generations to see. We as a group, we aim to, you know, highlight the fact that we as youth, we need to bring a change in our behavior towards our environment, which is our responsibility to protect. Another thing, we as a group are planting trees in different parks of Jaipur. So far we've covered Ramnagar area of Sodala, we've covered Sistim area, we've covered a few sectors of Mansarovar, and also we've covered Rajapak and other nearby areas.
So we are on the verge of extinction, and we need to save our planet Earth. We are the future heroes of saving our planet Earth, and we need to think about each and every resource available here. If we talk about birds, they are equally important as we human beings are. And if we talk about plantations, the plantation gives us oxygen and food and other multiple things. So we need to think about our plantations, animals, and all of such resources which are available on planet Earth. Obviously, we are tenants on this place.